Hey everyone, welcome to an updated mini quest guide for In Memory of the Myreki. I'm not exactly sure if I pronounced that right, but I'm probably going to get that down in the comments, so I'll just put that in right now. The overview and the requirements of this quest are as follows. It's considered a Grandmaster mini quest and is available after the completion of the Lord of Vampirium quest. There are no other requirements for this mini quest. Now for the items needed. In total, you will need 20 granite, which is the 5 kg, 10 blisterwood sickles, 1 nail beast nails, 1 snake skin body, 1 Ivandis flail, 1 rune armored boots, 1 moonlight mead, 1 blue blamish shell, pointed, or blamish blue shell, however you want to say it, 1 blisterwood stake thrower crossbow, 1 histories of the Hollowland, 1 holy water, and 1 Mortmire pear. To start this quest, head over to the Caniphus Lodestone and head northwest into a graveyard with a circle-type structure on the eastern side, then speak to Veliaf Hertz. Once you've spoken to Veliaf, he is going to ask you to build a monument to honor allies lost in the Myreki quest series. Unfortunately, you are only able to build one monument per day, which refreshes at game time, which requires 2 granite of the 5 kg and 1 blisterwood sickle. Once Veliaf has placed the plinth, you are able to start building the monuments. This is where all these random little items come into play from earlier. Each item is paired to a specific character which is used to build that specific monument. I will place images of what each character requires for the monument to be built, and this adds up to a total of 10 characters over the course of 10 days, and I will be putting these in order. So I'll go ahead and throw those up on the screen now, and you guys can go ahead and use this guide over the course of the next 10 days to complete this mini quest. After you've completed all the monuments, speak to Veliaf once again, and that is the mini quest complete. As for the rewards, you will receive 20k construction XP and 10k prayer XP. If this video helped you out, please make sure to leave a like, and if you have any suggestions, please feel free to leave a comment. Thank you again for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.